Welcome back, 17 on set. Joining us this morning, Dave Anderson, a financial advisor from Moneywise, here to talk about how you can start saving now for your future college student, no matter how young your student is. Good morning, Dave. Great
Good
to
morning.
See you.
Thank you.
So I was looking up some numbers this morning, kind of preparing myself. The thought of paying for college is daunting for any parent, yeah. Especially if you have multiple children. According to College Board, the average cost of tuition and fees last year was $34,740. Per year at private colleges, around 10,000 for state residents at public universities, and 25,000 if you're an out-of-state resident at a public university. Again, this is just 1 year.
Right.
Typically, we're looking at four.
Right.
How do you even begin to save?
Well, the first thing to note specifically about those numbers that you gave her, those are the retail costs. Mm-hmm. So most students do not end up paying the retail costs. They pay far less than that. And the idea is the sooner you start planning, the sooner you start preparing, the more options you're going to have. So it's never too soon to start. Start now.
Okay. Child just being born. Start now.
Yep. Start now. And what you would do if you just have a newborn is start funding maybe a college savings plan.
Okay.
A 529 plan is a great place to start. You put money in this account. It grows and earns interest over the years. Once you take it out for school, it comes out tax-free. So you have some tax advantages, and you've been saving for all of these years as well.
Do you need a separate account for each child, or do you just need one account?
You can do separate accounts, or you can do one account. With the 529, the parent actually, or whoever opened it up, a grandparent, mm-hmm. they own the account. The beneficiary is the child. If that one child doesn't want to go to school, and you're going to use that money for another child, you can use that same account and just change the beneficiary.
So the rule here, though, is that the money has to be used for to pay for education.
Correct. And that can be tuition, it can be room and board, to buy a computer. Okay. If it ends up not being used for education, the parent can take the money back, but it's going to cost them taxes and they'll pay a 10% penalty.
Okay, what if I have a third grader or a fifth grader and I haven't started saving yet? What do I do?
Start saving. That's key. What a lot of people do is they feel like they haven't started soon mm-hmm. enough, and so they just delay it even more. Start saving now. Make sure that you have some sort of plan. And then if you don't have a lot of money to save for college, you really want to start researching loan programs, grant options, because there's a lot of programs out there that can help.
All right, Dave Anderson, here's some more information on the screen. If you want some more advice, there it is. Thank you so much for joining us this morning.
You bet.
I appreciate it. I'm going to get started, I promise.
Great.
We'll be right back after this.